So, today we're going to perform a Gearbox software update using the VCP or VAC-CANFO diagnostic tool. Of course, the first step is to start up the tool on our PC and connect the interface to the car, followed by preparation of the flash file. The flash file can be downloaded from RoadTracker, for example. There are flash files for all VAC issues available, for example, flash.n 2024. And we need the file to be prepared in an FRF format or ODX format. We start the ignition and, of course, turn off all consumers and having the battery maintainer connected during the process. After that, we open the Gearbox page in VCP, and after a successful communication establishment, we click on the flasher button on the right of the window, and after that, we can select our flash file. We need to make sure that the file corresponds to the Gearbox part number, also with the letters at the end. And we need to select our flash file format, ODX or FRF file. In this case, it's the FRF file. And we select it. Then we'll see on the top the summary with the file part number and our actual part number of the gearbox. We make sure that they matches. And after that, we can click flash CGO button. This will initiate the flashing process of the gearbox. Once started the process, we will see numerous of warnings on the dashboard, which is completely normal because now the gearbox is not communicating with the rest of the vehicles, and we will start to see the flashing progress in the VCP window. This will take some time, maybe between 5 and 10 minutes depending on your gearbox, so that's why it's always important to have the battery maintainer connected to the vehicle. Make sure that you will not be stranded without a battery in this finishing process. This could damage the ECU. So here we already see that the first part of the flashing process is completed. Then we jump to the next data block that needs to be written. Depending on your gearbox and software, there will be multiple flash blocks that needs to be flashed. Some will flash quicker, some will flash longer. And once the process is completed, here you can see that it's already 8 minutes into the flashing process. And after that, the VCP will show, once completed, the ECU reset command, and it will ask us to cycle the ignition off and on again. After we cycle the ignition, we should see a confirmation from VCP that connection is established again, or we can directly close the flashing window and manually verify the connection of the gearbox. Here in my case, I don't update the version because it's already on the latest version, but in case of updating the software version, here you see your new software version on the right in the identification window. And once we select our our vehicle model, we will see the new software version that's being flashed. And now the next step is to perform a gearbox adaptation, stationary or in motion, which will take a look in a separate video. This could be done with VCDS, the driving adaptation, or with all this, the stationary or standstill adaptation. And we're done.